Hola.
In every generation, they stand. In every generation, they serve. In every generation, they sacrifice. For 2.5 centuries on land.
Hello, how's it going? Happy Memorial Day. If you say something, I'll scroll up and read it in a second. Welcome to Periscope. I was going to talk on hour two, but I figured, hey, too much to say. I'm going to start right now. It's going to eat a couple avocados, but I can wait. It's only midnight. Hope you're safe, well, healthy, good, all that good stuff. I won't blow my own horn. I just like to listen and think and respond. I love America. My grandpa fought in World War II and in the Korean War. My uncle fought in Vietnam. My dad and other uncle were enlisted. Well, my dad was drafted.
Our nation's fallen heroes. A few lines in there just, you know, make us stand out so much on this Memorial Day. They fought and died for an idea bigger than themselves. They are the bold angels, examples to us all. And, you know, we watched, Meek and I began watching again this weekend, because you've never seen it, Band of Brothers, and got through the first 3 or 4 episodes. And, you know, as you watch that, and as you look at not only the greatest generation, but this generation as well, and the sacrifices that have been made, that are still being made to protect this country, you really do ask yourself that often repeated question, where do we find such men and such women? Where do
bring
we
the
find
troops
such
home.
Heroes? Today is the day.
Ask Biden why he voted for the Iraq war.
Remember them, and we honor them the way we should honor them every day.
Good morning and welcome to Morning Joe. It is Monday, May 25th. With us, we have White House reporter for the Associated Press, Jonathan Lemire.
War is hell, man. Don't ever think otherwise.
Eddie Flaw, Jr.
War affects families, affects people
White
for
House
life.
State Department's Elise Jordan and former NATO Supreme Allied Commander, retired 4-star Navy Admiral James DeBrides. He is Chief International Security and Diplomacy Analyst for NBC News and MSNBC.
Admiral, let's begin with you. And we actually got you here to talk about a lot of different things, to talk about China, to talk about the handling of this pandemic and how we do better moving forward, because you've obviously led.
I'm ready to hear the liberal spin on it.
So
what about you?
Had to
tell me what the Democratic Party thinks. because it said 99,300 deaths in the U.S. yesterday. It's called worldometer.info/coronavirus. And I've been following that for weeks now. And it's always a little higher than the mainstream media. And I doubt they're counting people that are dead that are not really dead. I think the mainstream media is not counting some people that have already died. So be that as it may, you know, 100,000 Americans or 100,000 people in America died from the 2019 novel coronavirus on Memorial Day 2020. Joe Biden's comments didn't bother me at all. I'm interested in what black people think. But Joe Biden made a joke. You know what a joke is? Joe Biden laughed when he said it. He was trying to be funny. You got to cut people some slack if they make a joke, even if it's stupid. And at least he tried to make a joke. And you got to take it in context. He didn't offend McKelvey. Leonard McKelvey didn't stand up and say, "You crossed the line, buddy. That's too far."
Donald Trump is called a black woman who
we're not comparable, man. And here they are. This is a false dichotomy. See, the Democratic Party is used to playing the card that goes, pick the lesser of the two evils and wear it. But I heard something wise one time, and it goes like this. The lesser of two evils is still evil. And these people earned their money honestly. They followed the rules. You want to see the people that are dishonest about the money, you'll never get their money. They're keeping their money overseas and offshore banks, and you don't even know how much they got, and you can't touch it, and you'll never get to it. They're talking about taking people's money that did things the right way, and they have it in America, and that created jobs. Yeah, that's one thing I was a positive for Donald Trump is because you could see that he created jobs. How? Well, they got the buildings with his name on them. People working inside of there, he created those jobs, and that was a good thing. Say what you want about him. But that was a verifiable proof of something positive that he did. All right, on the Fox. Let's see what's up here.
Important mask where he is to prevent those droplets from reaching others. Our next guest says there are responsible ways that Americans can return to normalcy. Here with more is Fox News medical contributor and author of Make America Healthy Again, Dr. Nicole Sapphire. Good morning, Dr. Sapphire.
Hey, good morning, Ainsley.
Good morning. You see those images. I like your shirt, by the way. That's beautiful. You see these images of people on the beach. How can we return to normalcy and do it safely?
Well, Ainsley, this isn't a weekend about celebrating the
fall. Go straight to the beach and then go straight home. Has anybody said that? You know, I think it's, if you don't want to get this virus, you might not want to go to the beach. Have you ever smelled a cigarette on the beach? I have. I've smelled cigarettes from the beach.